Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and I'm here today with musicteacher.com. In this video, we're going to learn the technique of hammer-ons. So all the tones you're hearing in this video are coming from my Stanford Crossroads Marquee, which is a Les Paul style guitar, which is plugged into the Blackstar Studio 10 6L6, which is running on the drive channel, and the amp is going via the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X straight into my Focusrite interface. So the Captor X is acting as a IR loader, so you're not hearing the speaker in the room, you're hearing a digital speaker simulation from the Captor. So hammer-on is a technique that you're going to use a lot on your guitar journey. It's from a family of techniques known as legato. This means to join together. So there are a bunch of different techniques in this field. Hammer-ons, pull-offs, slides, and string bends all fall into this category of notes that we can join together without picking again. There are many players like Joe Satriani who use legato as long fluid passages as big part of their playing style. Today we're just going to look at hammer-ons in the basic form to get your fingers going and get this technique integrated into your playing. So here's how the technique sounds. So you may have noticed there I was getting two notes, but I was only picking once. This technique involves playing a note, so I'm going to be using the fifth fret here on the D string as an example. I'm going to play that note with my pick. Then with my third finger, I'm going to hammer onto the seventh fret of the same string. So this hammering motion is going to create a second note. I can do this on any string I want. When you're first starting out with this, you may find that the hammering motion is a little bit weak because your fingers won't have the strength. Don't worry about that, just persevere and try to get that hammer a little harder, because the harder you hammer on, the more clear the second note will sound. You'll know if you're not hammering hard enough because it will sound like this. You can see how that second note either completely dies or it loses its energy. You really want to get that finger to hammer on, as the name suggests. So I'm going to show you two exercises now to really help your hammer-ons get stronger. The first exercise is going to work on your hammer-ons for each finger. So take a note, it doesn't matter where you place this note, but I'm going to start on the fifth fret of the high E string. And I'm going to play this note, and I'm going to hammer onto the sixth fret with my middle finger. So I'm getting two separate notes there. Then I'm going to play the fifth fret again, and I'm going to hammer onto the seventh fret with my third finger. Then I'm going to do the same thing, but this time it's going to be my little finger and the eighth fret. So altogether we've got six with the middle finger, seven with the third finger, eight with the little finger. This is a really great way to start building up that finger strength. It's tricky to learn to hammer on with multiple fingers, but that is a good exercise for starting to do that. What you can do is you can break it out into groups of four. So you could do six, seven, eight, seven, and then repeat the whole thing. So you're going six, seven, eight, seven, six, seven, eight, seven. Over time, the hammer-ons will become cleaner and faster, and you can start to speed this up as your fingers get tougher. But don't worry about the speed straight away, just focus on getting those hammer-ons super, super clean. The second exercise is going to use a scale shape. This is going to use a scale called the minor pentatonic scale. So basically, I'm just going to be playing that scale shape with hammer-ons. So I'm going to play the fifth fret on the low E string and hammer on the eighth of the low E string with my little finger. On the A, D, and G strings, it's going to be the fifth with the index finger and the seventh with the ring finger. And on the B and E strings, it's going to be the fifth with the index finger and the eighth with the little finger. So we've got 5 and 8, 5 and 7, and 5 and 8 again on the last two strings. And all together, those two exercises will get your fingers used to doing hammer-ons. It's a tricky technique to start with if you've not built up the strength in the fingers, but once you've done it for a few days, you should start to see that hammer-on note becoming a lot clearer, and you will feel like you're not having to use as much force to get the note to ring out true. Those exercises will also help train the different fingers on your hand to start doing hammer-ons as well. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this quick lesson on hammer-ons. Let us know down below in the comments how you got on with this, and also let us know if there are any techniques you'd like to see us break down in these videos. Don't forget to check out PMTVUK on YouTube for more videos just like this. There's a bunch of other free lessons on the channel, so go check those out as well. And if you're looking for a music teacher in your local area, don't forget to check out musicteacher.com. They have a great network of teachers all around the country waiting to help you guys out. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.